I was saying that in the next 30 minutes or so, I'm going to explain how big data and artificial intelligence is helping a company, a telco company such as Telefónica, in the digital transformation, and how we can also help other companies to go through the same journey. Digital transformation is a buzzword, everybody's talking about that, but what does it mean for a company, for us? There are many things that are very similar to other sectors. Clearly, our customers, our employees are already digital, and they are changing the demand, so they are not settling with an average offering, they are requesting something very personalized. And on the other hand, we have competitors. There are new competitors, digital competitors that are bringing to the market no legacies, no transitions, and that really disrupting the whole ecosystem of the sectors. But these are things that we are sharing with other sectors, with the banking industry, with the real retail industry, with hotels, with transportation industry. What is different in our case is that we are also playing a different role in the digital transformation. We are the enablers, so we put the connectivity. So we have a huge pressure on investments. We need to develop the 3G, 4G, 5G networks, fiber, and this is bringing a lot of pressure in terms of investments while our revenues are, at best, staying flat. That's why digital transformation is not an option for us, and we are working in a deep transformation. We are putting the company upside down, and we are transforming the whole company. We are seeing the company as a platform company, where we are changing the way we develop our networks. This is what we call first platform. We are also digitalizing end-to-end and simplifying the process of our systems, our second platform. On top of that, we are changing the way we develop products and services, and here is the important thing, the glue that is bringing together the whole company is data. So we are creating, and we have been working on that several years, what we call fourth platform, that is leveraging what all the data that is generated in the first, second, and third platforms, and we are applying on top of that artificial intelligence and cognitive intelligence to extract value for the customer out of the data. We can say now that data is at the center of the digital transformation, and this fourth platform is already a reality in more than 10 countries. Half of our customers, 178 million mobile customers, are already in this fourth platform, where we have normalized the data, so we have a common language in all the countries. We also have the same kind of APIs, and we have the same technology components, anonymizer, authentificator, so we can scale the development of our big data and artificial intelligence services. And we are using now big data and artificial intelligence, I would say, everywhere. Yeah, but specifically for three things. The first one is to change the way we take decisions at Telefónica. So it's what we call internal use cases. And we use this fourth platform output to increase our revenue line, to reduce our cost and optimize our investments. So the TV content recommendations are the way we recommend, for instance, devices, how we manage churn, how we decide to deploy at network, so it's everywhere. And very recently, we are also working a lot in robotics, in automating our processes through RPA. The second way we are using artificial intelligence is to change how we relate with the customers, our relationship with the customers. You will probably have heard of Aura. This is our brain, the brain that we have in Telefónica on top of our data, and it's changing the way we interact with the customers, personalizing and making their relationship with Telefónica much easier, and is also accessible through different channels. And the third way we are using big data and artificial intelligence is through Luca. Luca is the business unit that we launched 3 years ago to help other companies to go through the same journey, to extract value out of the data. And what we have done is combine different assets that we have, of course, our internal experiences and services that we have developed on top of our data to help other companies to really extract value out of the data. Let me show you a short video that summarizes the kind of work we do in Luca.
La realidad en la que hoy vivimos es radicalmente distinta a la de hace unas décadas. Es una vida conectada, una vida digital. Las tecnologías tienen un peso mayor que nunca en la forma de hacer negocio y de entender la sociedad e interactuar con ella. El Big Data y la inteligencia artificial potencian y magnifican nuestras capacidades como seres humanos, haciéndonos más informados, más eficientes, finalmente mejores. Telefónica, en su apuesta clara en convertirse en una organización AI-driven y en ayudar a sus clientes corporativos a que también lo sean, creó la unidad de datos Luca, haciendo así accesible el Big Data y la inteligencia artificial a las empresas y las administraciones públicas. En Luca ofrecemos un portfolio muy amplio con soluciones para todos los sectores, que cubren desde el ámbito financiero hasta el retail, pasando por el turismo, transporte y la industria. Te ayudamos a definir la estrategia en Big Data e inteligencia artificial para tu organización, a través de nuestros servicios de consultoría estratégica y programas formativos, gracias a nuestro equipo de profesionales en estas disciplinas. Brindamos servicios de analítica avanzada con datos provenientes del cliente, de las redes y servicios de Telefónica y de Internet de las Cosas, así como de otras fuentes externas, para encontrar patrones ocultos e insights de negocio que nos permitan predecir comportamientos en los consumidores, garantizando siempre la privacidad de nuestros clientes. Asimismo, ofrecemos soluciones de marketing y publicidad a través de la gestión inteligente de tus campañas. El Big Data y la inteligencia artificial son el presente. Es el momento de que formen parte de tu organización y te permitan potenciar tus capacidades y mejorar la toma de decisiones estratégicas. Te ayudamos a liberar el poder de tus datos. Luca, Telefónica Data Unit.
This is what we do at Luca. And after 3 years, we are proud to say that we have been done and collaborating with more than 300 customers in more than 600 projects. And we are a global unit, so we work in the different countries where Telefónica has footprint in Europe and Latin America. And we have been also been recognized as one of the leaders in the business insights category. This is a report from Forrester, the industry analyst firm, where selected Telefónica as leader in the category of business insights, and this is a research that was done globally. And why is that? What they were saying is that we have the capability of putting together all the pieces that a company, a big corporation, a public administration, a smaller firm, needs in order to start this journey, this fascinating journey of using data. Basically, what we do with customers is two things. The first one is helping them to create their own capabilities in terms of resources, in terms of infrastructure, in terms of tools. And the second one is helping them to extract value from the data by combining their own data with external sources and also with services that we have developed on top of our 350 million customers globally. And what is important in order to help them take better decisions based on data is that we are following an industry-specific approach. So we develop platforms, we develop services, but we always are helping them with an industry-specific approach that helps them integrate it into their business processes. Let me show you how we do the first thing, creating capabilities in the customers. Something that is important is to align the strategy, the big data, artificial intelligence strategy, with the whole strategy of the company. And that's why we use our professional services. We acquire a company, Synergic Partners, that was leader in this category in 2015. And with that, we have a selected group of professionals that cover all the skills that are needed in this kind of projects. Data scientists, data architects, data engineers, visualization experts, business analysts. And with that, we have defined our own methodology to help the customers with a very practical approach, with some kind of services, such as the use case discovery, where in a 2-6 weeks period, we are helping the customers to define and prioritize the use cases for big data, or our data-driven assessments, where we can assess where is the customer in terms of technology, in terms of data access, data governance, people, and help them define their roadmap in each of these categories and how to move it. And even we can accompany the customers once they have acquired a certain degree of maturity. For instance, with their Luca Academy, we are helping them to transform the company and to evolve the capabilities of the organization. Once we have that, it's important to combine and to extract value from the data. And for that, we have our analytics services. We have these professionals working with the customer in specific use cases. And in this case, what we are is very flexible. We are our role, as I say, is to develop the capabilities in the customer, not just to stay in the customer forever. So we are following a very flexible approach where we can work with them, for instance, of course, in an end-to-end project with very clear outputs and put them in a productive way. Or even we can work with them in different models, such as extended teams, where we combine our capabilities with their capabilities, and we are transferring methodology and the way we work in Luca, or Center of Excellence, or even we can develop analytics services as a service, so they don't need to have all the capabilities. We are able to help them whenever they need it. One thing we are doing in order to transfer these capabilities is to open with our customers tools that we have developed for ourselves. And I'm going to show you one of the examples. It's something that we are launching this year that is called Luca Suite. Luca Suite is a machine learning development tool that we developed for ourselves because we have two needs to cover, and we couldn't find any other market tools. The first one is to reutilize and being able to have accelerators to help our data scientists to be more productive and more efficient when developing projects with the customers. But the second thing was we felt that we have the need to improve the communication with our customers, but not with the technical guys, but with the business guys, the ones that are taking the decision. And that's why we developed Luca Suite for ourselves, and now we are opening up for our customers. Let me show you in this video what Luca Suite looks like.
One of the main challenges to face when developing machine learning projects is the disconnection between technical and business teams. Luca Suite has been designed to break these barriers, creating a common space where all users share the same language. Besides, it creates a framework to lead the teams through the model creation, automatizing all the steps in the way. Data profiling, to fully understand the data and uncover quality-related issues. Variables transformation. Make your dataset machine learning compliance. Model training. Combines different algorithms to find the one that suits you better. Model exploration to understand and power the model. Analyze the population according to their probability. Activate the model, creating segments and calculating the ROI of the action. Set it up on production using the perfect probability. Thanks to all those functionalities, Luca Suite entails a true differential value for companies. Let us make AI easier for you.
This is Luca Suite, and we are very excited because we are receiving very good feedback from the customers. As I say, it's something that our own data scientists are already using, but we are we think that we are covering this relationship between the technical guys and the business guys, and being able to explain what the big data can do for them. One important thing is, of course, this is compatible with any other tool. So we are building on top of the other things, the other tools that existed in the market, but we are covering this gap that we felt that it was there in the big data space. How we are also helping the customers to develop their own tools. We are providing them with infrastructure. It's important. We are an infrastructure company, and we are helping them with a full stack approach. We are offering the customers to build their own technology by combining all the pieces that are needed. We can offer, of course, the infrastructure piece, the data piece to use the data and to introduce models, data governance model, and the analytics piece to work on top of that to make sure that we extract the value, and all with security and with privacy. What we are doing is combining our own capabilities as Telefónica with the best in class partners. And of course, Stratio is one of the partners we are working with in not only in Spain, but also in Latin America. By combining our own technology with our partners, what we are trying to do is to avoid the complexity for the customers of managing the whole ecosystem. We are putting all the pieces together, and we can manage this complexity for them so they can concentrate on the business. And this is something that is working, as I say, not only in Spain, but we are working with customers in all the footprint of Telefónica, in Latin America, and in Germany, UK, and Spain. And more customers of different sectors, of different sizes, are trusting on us to help them through go through this transformation. We have talked about the development of capabilities in the customers through our professional services, our tools, and our infrastructure. But what is really unique from us, by being a telco company, is that we are helping them to combine their own data with the data that we have in Telefónica. And this is what I'm covering right now. We know that the power of big data, comes from combining different pieces of information and being able to make them available in a fast and in the right way. What we have done is take advantage of the huge amount of data that we have in our network by being a telco company, At the end of the day, the mobile phone is an identifier of the activity of the population. We always are with our mobile phones from the very early in the morning until we go to sleep. And in our networks, what we are doing is to process billions and billions of events. What we have done in Luca is to develop platforms that deal with this data in a secure and private way. What we are doing is first anonymize the data, so we are eliminating every personal aspect of the data, so we just know that there is a certain point that has a behavior over time. We aggregate the data also as a privacy measure, and we extrapolate the data to represent the whole population. And with that, we are working in different projects to help the customers to better understand their consumers. So this is very complementary to other sources, to more traditional sources of using data, such as the surveys or applications, mobile applications, but have a lot of advantages for the customers. Because first, you have the granularity of millions customers, not just hundreds as in a survey. You may have the historic information that you needed. You also have profiling, and even is not invasive for the customer. And what we have done is elaborate a portfolio of services that I'm going to show you in a moment to combine this data with the data from the customers. Always, of course, and I can't emphasize enough, following not just the regulation, GDPR, but even going beyond, because privacy and security of our customers' data is the most important aspect. And what we have is develop a portfolio of services. I'm going to just show you a glimpse of some of them. But there are like four categories. The first one is the one I was talking about, the ground analytics. And actually, for those of you that were in the previous session with Miguel, this is the kind of data that we are also using, not just for our customers, for our B2B customers, but we were collaborating with them in big data for social good projects, the one that he mentioned in SICA. We are using the same data and the same platforms, not only for commercial purposes, but also to help the society, because they has the same value. But we are using this ground analytics. We also have some services that are consent-based services. In this case, it's personal information. It's a B2B2C service where we always have a benefit for both the company and the consumer client. We have also developed a set of services on top of IoT. This analytical layer on top of IoT, and even an enterprise communication tool to help them improve the services that they buy from Telefónica in terms of mobile, fixed, or even CRM information. Let's start with the ground analytics. That the important thing is use this understanding of the movements of the population, how the population moves from one place to the other, this micro segment, to answer specific questions of specific sectors. And these are some examples of the kind of work that we are doing with the transport industry, with media, with tourism, and with retail. For instance, for transportation, both public and private companies, they need to better understand how the population moves in order to develop or to deploy new infrastructure, a metro line, a highway, and we are helping them to understand that, to really invest in a more efficient way. We have been working, for instance, with most companies, transport companies in the UK, Transport for London, Highways England, also here in Spain and Latin America. Another use of our platform is the media industry. In this case, we are helping them to answer different questions. In this case, they need to better plan and measure the efficiency of their marketing campaigns. And we are helping them also, as you can see, with the logos of the most representative companies in this space. Another use is tourism. In countries such as Spain, where tourism is an important part of the GDP, we can help both the public sector, the cities, the destination, the tourism destinations, and also some other players in the value chain, such as hotels, hotel chains, to better understand where are the visitors, where are they coming from, for how long they stay, what other places are they visiting, and in this case, we can differentiate between the residents, the visitors, and in the visitors, if they are national, if they are coming from abroad, from which countries. So we have set a tool that answers all these questions for these kind of companies. And last is the retail industry. In this case, we are talking here not just retail as commercial centers or shopping centers, but as anybody that has a specific point where they receive customers. It may be oil stations, banking branches, and of course, commercial centers. They really need to understand what is happening, what is the potential of the customers, especially now that they are competing with some online players. And here we are helping them to replicate the same metrics that they have in the online world, but in the physical world. And this is a sector where we are working very, very heavily with them. And what we are doing in this kind of services is evolving. Of course, we are incorporating new sources of data, new external sources, and we are evolving the services to make sure that they are all API sectors, so they can integrate, the customer can integrate these insights into their own decisions, into their own processes and systems. That's Crown Analytics. The second one is consent-based services. Here, as I say, since it is a personal data point, we always need an explicit consent of the customer. And we always offer to the consumer a benefit so they can accept to provide the consent. What kind of services do we have here? Well, for instance, we are working on fraud prevention, since the messaging, the SMS, is one of the sources as a second factor authentication. For instance, whenever there is a financial transaction, most of us receive a message in our phone to confirm that we want to realize this, to perform this transaction, and there is fraud around it. So what we are providing a service, in this case, is carrier service, so we are working with the other telco operators to provide the same services, where we can confirm to the bank if there has been a SIM swap in the recently. So we can prevent fraud by using data from the customer. And another service that we have developed in this space and we are working is in improve the risk management process. We have data in our company that is very useful when we combine it with the data that, for instance, in this case, a financial institution has. So through Luca scoring, we can improve the scoring that the financial institutions have, or even to reach to incremental customers where they don't have information. So once we have the consent of the customer, we can work here in two different flavors. One is what we call pret-a-porter, so where we have predefined algorithms working just with the data that we have in Telefónica, but we can also work in a second way, that is the tailor offering, where we combine data from the customer, from the financial institution, and our own data, and we improve the scoring. This is something that is already available here in Spain, and we're working with the financial institutions. And again, it's something that is GDPR compliant and is also API based. The third category is, of course, IoT. We all know that IoT is growing exponentially in the last years and is expected to grow even more as we sensorize not just the objects, but also the people. So there is particularities of working with sensors, with IoT data, that we need to take into account. It's a huge amount of data, sometimes it's narrow data, but there are some characteristics that make IoT different. Sometimes it's a streaming data, it's very important real-time analytics, sometimes it's analytics on the edge. And there are some aspects such as privacy, security, interoperability, latency, that is important to work in a different way. And what we have done in Luca is combine our capabilities with the capabilities of the IoT team in Telefónica to further improve our offering and offer something that is end-to-end. Of course, starting with the connectivity, with the management of the SIMs, with the basic analytics that comes in this kind of tools, and we are complementing that with our professional services, so we are combining and evolving our offering in IoT by combining IoT data with data that the customer already has and other data, and going towards a more sophisticated analytics, and especially putting together IoT data into the rest of the decision-making of the customers. These are some of the sectors where we are applying already our combined IoT and big data offering. It's retail, combining the outdoors that I showed you before with the indoors data, clearly mobility with our fleet management solution, smart cities, manufacturing, and also utilities. There is a lot of projects going on this space, and this is something that we think we are very well positioned. And finally, we are working also putting an analytic layer on top of our more traditional services, the communication services. I'm not going to talk about this because I've seen one of our colleagues is having a specific speech this afternoon, Álvaro Sánchez, on that. But that's the complete set of services that we have deployed on top of our data. And there is a lot of innovation. So what is next? What we are doing with Luca and Telefónica is to open up the home of our customers. So we have a strong presence in our customers' home with equipment, with TV set, routers. And what we are doing is getting AI-powered experiences on top of this presence that we have in the homes of our customers, working with different customers and putting together with some of the players that you have seen here, AI-powered experiences to the customers. This is our new thing. We have already launched it, but I won't spoil it because, again, in this case, my boss, Chema Alonso, the CDO, the Chief Data Officer of Telefónica, will have a speech this afternoon in the same theater. But keep tuned because this is something really big, and we are very excited about what is coming. So this is what we are doing in Luca. As I say, after these 3 years of experience, where we have been how the big data space has been growing, how the customers are maturing and using more and more artificial intelligence for their businesses. And we will be happy to work with any of you to help develop these capabilities. Thank you very much.